Hello everyone. Today I am going to tell you a story. The title itself will reveal you its meaning. So students, the title is Unexpected Party from Hobbits, written by J.R.R. Tolkien. Now students, do you know what is the meaning of unexpected? Yeah, unexpected means something surprising or something you are not desired for. And as we all know, that parties are always to enjoy. So let us see what is there in this chapter, Unexpected Party. And students, do you know about hobbits? Hobbits are the members of an imaginary race. Similar to humans, they are of small size with hairy feet. Now, let me introduce you with the characters of this chapter. So, there are altogether 14 characters in this chapter. Bilbo, the host, and all these are the dwarves. So, do you know children who are dwarves? Dwarves are people much smaller than the usual human size. So, these all are the dwarves. Gandalf, Balin, Dwalin, Fili, Kili, Dori, Ori, Oin, Gloin, Bifur, Bofur, Bomber, and Thorin. Now, I would like to tell you about the theme of the story. So, the story depicts three main attributes of Bilbo as bravery, greed, and luck. The dwarves were not so well-mannered, but they treated well when they visited to Bilbo's house. You know why? Because that time they were the guests. At the same time, Bilbo did not get panic and served them food very patiently. So, a guest as well as a host must have his or her own identity and should behave accordingly. Now, I would like to show you the mind map so the chapter would be more clear to you. The story starts with Bilbo. So Bilbo was ready to have his tea in his house. At that time, the door knocked and Dwalin, a dwarf, came to his house. Bilbo opened the door and asked him to come inside. Then Bilbo offered him tea, but Dwalin refused to have the tea. Then Dwalin was invited next day for the tea again. And you know, in this way, there are 13 dwarves who came to his house one by one. And they transformed the tea time to an organizational meeting. Bilbo was very rich, so he was able to serve them food. They enjoyed the food together, they danced, they sang, they behaved nicely with Bilbo there. They did not create any problem at Bilbo's place. And after having food, what did they do, you know? They cleaned out the kitchen. Through their song, they told everything to Bilbo about their adventurous trip and asked Bilbo to play the central role as a professional thief to reclaim their treasures which were stolen by Smaug a dragon. So altogether we can say that it was an unexpected party for the dwarves, which they enjoyed too much at Bilbo's place. Now let us move on to the summary of the chapter. The story is about dwarves who were 13 in number and they came to Bilbo's house as guests. Unexpectedly. Bilbo was from a well-to-do family. He was a respectful man, but never had any adventures. He was quiet and happy with his life. He liked to live in that comfort zone without any interruptions. One day, he was ready to have his tea. At that time, the doorbell rang. Dwalin was the first one to knock the door. When Bilbo opened the door, he found Dwalin standing over there. Bilbo got nervous and and surprised to see him. You know why? Because he was expecting Gandalf. He was flustered what to do. But he offered him tea, but Dwalin refused to have tea that day. Then he invited him for the tea the next day. Just after some time, Balin, another dwarf, came and knocked the door. He was Dwalin's brother. Bilbo invited him to get in, knowing that he was Dwalin's brother. In this way, 13 dwarves came to his place one after another. You just imagine what had been the situation and scenario at the time at Bilbo's house. Bilbo was surprised to see them at his door one by one. Bilbo was showing his hospitality to them, and the dwarves were also behaving him with manner. The one for whom Bilbo was expecting the most came at the last with the most haughty dwarf. Haughty means a person who was very proud of his power or quality. So the dwarf came at the last, whose name was Thorin. Bilbo served them food very patiently. Although the dwarves were ill-mannered, they did not do anything wrong at Bilbo's house. The dwarves played there, they sang there, they danced, they enjoyed there, but behaved respectfully with Bilbo. The scene at Bilbo's house showed us both the roles perfectly. How the guest as well as the host should behave when somebody visits to a house. The dwarves and the wizard behaved so gently that they cleaned out Bilbo's kitchen even before they settled down to discuss their business matter. And their business matter was what, you know? They wanted Bilbo to lead them to the mountain and get their stolen treasure from there. The dwarves sang of the dwarves who lived beneath the mountains and mined gold and jewels. They were attacked by the dragon and drove them out of their house. They were all singing that the dwarves should claim for their treasures. When Bilbo heard this, he also desired to go for such adventurous trips, but he did not do that. You know why? Because very soon it disappeared from his mind. He was a timid person and he did not want to take any adventurous trip with the end of the music. That is why everything disappeared from his mind with the end of the music. So, the moral of the story which we get is that we should always be courteous and kind to our guests and have patience. Thank you. Stay safe.